Good morning. Today we have here a Volvo FM12 V2. Today we have to unmount the gearbox to fix some component on it. I will take the opportunity to show you how to carry out the calibration on the E-Shift gearbox which comes from this truck. Follow me. To carry out this calibration, we will use Jaltest 20.2 version, the industry-leading multi-brand diagnostic tool in the market. The first operation that we have to do is to connect Jaltest interface to the gearbox and power supply the system. I will carry out the calibration with the interface connected by USB, but we can also use it with Bluetooth connection. Once on Jaltest software, we have to follow the path in truck, Volvo brand, select the FM series, and in the list, you will find the FM12 V2 from where this gearbox has been dismounted. Select the model, and we will have to look for the transmission system. You can also sort by system family to find it more easily. Pay attention that clicking on the diagnosis symbol, you can find different information related to the connection. To be sure that the connection with the gearbox is working, we can proceed to a communication test. For that, we need to know which communication protocol is used in this gearbox. We can have this information in the wiring diagram available in Jaltest. In the left menu, click on diagram, select wiring diagram, accept. We are going to look for the diagnosis connector. Here we find it. We can see that it's a G1708 protocol which is running between pin 3 and 7. We can also see that the power supply is coming from pin 10 to 18. We are now going to proceed to the connection with the multi-pins following the information from the wiring diagrams. Don't forget to power supply Jaltest interface. The light on the interface should stop blinking. On the software, to confirm that the connection has been well made, we can proceed to a communication test. For that, out of the diagram section, select the main menu icon, click on Jaltest link, select communication mode, select your communication mode with the interface, here USB, and click on connection test. Once the connection established with the interface, click on Vehicle Bus Communication Test. Enter a value between 100 and 10,000, for example 500, and click on SAE G1708 Test. If a channel of communication is found, that means that the connection with the gearbox is working. If any channel is found, check your connection with the information from the wiring diagram. Accept and close the menu. Back on the transmission system, here we choose the connection number 3 as the gearbox is disassembled from the vehicle. We click on connect. Before to access to the system, you have to select the code of the gearbox. You can find the code on the rear side or on the upper side of the gearbox. Here we have a 80-25-12C gearbox. Select the code and accept. Once in the system, you could find different functionality. You could start with a diagnosis of the gearbox. As the gearbox is dismounted, it is normal that we will find a lot of fault code active. Now, out of the diagnosis and select the calibration. You have two possibilities, the calibration with gearbox installed in the vehicle or the calibration with gearbox not installed in the vehicle. This configuration helps to reduce workshop time and allow to perform a previous check before to install back the gearbox in the vehicle. In our case, we will select the second option. As we will be performing an action which will write in the control unit, we need an expert code. This code is totally free and it can be requested from your client area on our website, jaltest.com. Select the box and click on accept. The first page will give you a reminder about the operation and also some information related to the pinout of the diagnostics connector. Click accept to continue. Then we pass on the page with the initial condition to start the calibration. In our case, the gearbox have to be unfitted from the vehicle. The air pressure in the gearbox have to be between 6.5 and 10 bars. The power supply have to come from an external source with 20 to 24 volt for European vehicle and 10 to 12 volt for American brand. In case the condition are met, a green cross will appear next to the value. You are waiting that the pressure increase in the gearbox until at least 6.5. Once the green cross appear next to the value, it's okay. We can start the calibration. We click on accept. The calibration is now starting. Once finished, a message will be shown with calibration process completed. Click on accept to continue. Jaltest will show you the calibration value for each cylinder. We have the splitter cylinder, cylinder for reverse, neutral and first gear, cylinder for second, neutral and third gear, and finally the range cylinder. To complete the calibration, you have to switch off the alimentation for 10 seconds. The chronometer will help you to keep the good timing. For that, click on start and wait until the chronometer arrives at zero. Once at zero, you can now switch on the alimentation and click on accept. Click on accept. The calibration has been processed and is now over. To make sure any fault code has been generated during the calibration, you can click on the diagnostic symbol to carry out a scan on the gearbox. In our case, as the gearbox is dismounted, we will have the same fault code that we have seen at the beginning of the video. Click on accept. You can now disconnect from the system. After disconnecting, you can now unplug the cable from the gearbox and reinstall back the gearbox in the vehicle. I hope this guide has been helping you, and I thank you for following us.